morning and welcome to the second meeting in 2024 of the New York State Senate Committee on Housing Construction and Community Development. State Senator Brian Kavanaugh, Chair of the Committee. I'm joined in person here by Senators Borrello, Hilming, May, and Salazar. And it is a busy morning here in Albany. We may have other members joining us during the course of the meeting. And we also do have vote sheets from other members. And by virtue of those present and the vote sheets that have been submitted, we do have a quorum. We're also joined this morning by a number of staffers, including Morgan Simcoe, my chief of staff, on a special guest appearance here in Albany. Anthony Vassarolo, legislative director, Hallie Chu, housing committee director, Naomi Lazarus, our committee clerk, you'll be hearing from, Nairam Gasu, Bobby Barnett, Chris Friend, Rocio Chanez, are here.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Jess.
Yes.
Oh, and Jess Keenan off camera. All our staffers that support all of our work. Is there any opportunity for our minority leader, anyone else have any comments before we begin the agenda?
Nope, ready to get to the agenda.
Okay.
Thank you.
Just briefly, a little housekeeping. Since we last met, the governor has announced her budgetary and legislative priorities for the session. There are a series of significant proposals regarding housing. We will be having a joint budget hearing of the Housing and Finance and Ways and Means committees on February 14th. It's Valentine's Day, so an opportunity for everybody to express their love for housing and perhaps not be too verbose, so maybe all of us can get home at some point that day. The hearing will start at noon on February 14th. It's going to be an ongoing conversation. Several of the proposals today are proposals that also sometimes play into our budget negotiations. Several of the bills we're moving today are formally described as subject to appropriation. And obviously, to the extent we're spending money on housing and related needs, the budget process is the way to do that. And we do have, for those most people know, the budget is due by March 31st. So that'll be a robust discussion over the next 2 months. But I think we'll get to the particular bills and see if we have comments on that as we go. All right, so if the clerk would please read the first bill.
Yep. Bill S-130, Senate Sponsor Krueger, an act to amend the Emergency Tenant Protection Act of 1974 and the Administrative Code of the City of New York in relation to leasing business and other entities.
This is a bill we've seen before. It was recorded, this is a bill that was reported to the floor last year. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Okay, I've got a motion from Senator Jackson, who has joined us, second by Senator Salazar. Any negative votes?
AWR.
AWR. I got two to advance with our recommendation from the minority present, and the bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-568B, Senate Sponsor Kavanaugh, an act to amend the public housing law in relation to establishing the Housing Access Voucher Program.
This is a bill that was reported by this committee to finance last year and also a couple other years, and has been the subject of funding in our One House resolutions in both houses in previous budget cycles at an amount of $250 million. Very broad support from lots of tenant and housing advocates, but also from lots of folks who own property who prefer that when their tenants can't pay the rent, that we have a mechanism to do that. Any questions or comments or discussion?
Move the bill.
Got a motion from Senator Jackson, second from Senator Salazar. Any negative votes on this one?
Negative.
I've got a no.
AWR.
And AWR. A no from Senator Hilming, AWR from Senator Borrello. The bill is reported to finance. Next bill, please.
Bill S-688, Senate Sponsor May, an act to amend the executive law in relation to requiring certain housing production information to be reported to the Department of State.
And we'll be looking for a motion to report this to finance. This bill was passed by the Senate in 2023. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Okay, a motion from Senator Jackson. Any seconds on this one? Senator Salazar, to keep her speak up. Any negative votes?
Negative.
I've got Senator Rowe and Senator Hilming in the negative. Any votes to advance this bill without recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-2080, Senate Sponsor Kavanaugh, an act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to establishing an affordable independent senior housing assistance program.
And again, we'll be looking to, for a motion to report this bill to finance. We also reported to finance last year. Any questions or discussion?
So moved.
Okay, I've got, I have a comment or a question.
I have a question, yeah, or a comment anyway about, this is to be developed by the Division of Housing and Community Renewal in conjunction with the Department of Health. I hope NYSOFA will be included in that because they have a lot of experience with the assisted housing for.
Yeah, it's a good point. We can discuss it with the administration and perhaps formally add that. This is an existing program where we're attempting to add staff support for, for senior housing, and it is the current, because these are things that have been developed through existing agencies, we kind of focus on those agencies. But we will take that as a friendly amendment and perhaps add them to the bill text.
Thanks. I
have a comment to do on that.
Comment, please.
So when I'm talking to people and they ask me what are my priorities, and I say that my number one priority is the safety and security of the people that I represent in their homes and in our communities. But the second highest priority is housing. People coming into my office looking for housing. And senior housing is a major issue. When I go to the senior centers, and sometimes I ask a direct question, so you're renting a room, how much are you paying per week? Things like that. And many of the seniors don't have a lot of money. They depend on a Social Security or something else that they have, which is very little. And that's a major issue statewide, in my opinion. I know it is in New York City, senior housing. Housing is a human right, and we need to try to make sure that everyone, as per what the governor said last year, she's hoping to build how many units? 800,000.
I have a comment.
Great.
That's my comment.
Okay, we appreciate
it. And I support the bill.
Good. Thank you, Senator Hellman.
So I think, and I mentioned this at our first meeting of the year, that in our area, we also have seniors who are struggling, who are looking for housing alternatives. Mm-hmm. We have all people looking for affordable housing options. And by affordable, I don't mean like meeting the definition of the federal government or some of the state government regulations. Just people who are looking for housing that is more affordable. And one of the struggles is the cost of getting lots ready to build. Mm-hmm. I just had a conversation with a builder in the Monroe County area who was saying the cost now to build even just a single family residential, mm-hmm. just to get the lot with the infrastructure and your permits and everything else, it's $95,000. So there's no way, where we're trying to push to get homes more in that like 150 to 200,000 range, mm-hmm. there's no way when you're starting, your base cost is $95,000. And on infrastructure, when I brought it up at our first meeting, like that's one of the things that's holding back development in our area, is having access to public water or sewers or the upgrades that are needed to wastewater treatment plants or sewer treatment plants. We have people, Senator Harkin sponsoring a bunch of folks today who are talking about the funding that's available. At our first meeting, I was told, oh, there's lots of money for infrastructure. If you listen to what the folks who are the experts in the field are saying, Senator Harkin's people are here today, no, it's being proposed that there are cuts. So until we address, I think, property taxes, which are driving up the cost of building everything, the infrastructure, we're going to continue to have problems.
Okay. And there are a number of bills that we've already considered that are intended to facilitate construction. There are, it's a question of what, again, last year, the governor proposed an increase of $250 million for infrastructure annually. The Senate proposed it, the Senate majority in the One House resolution proposed to double that. It is an ongoing issue. We respect that and agree with it. And we will spend, I think, quite a bit of time in the work of this committee trying to ensure that there's an ability to construct new housing, try to, some of us would like to get some of the administrative burdens and other things that prevent housing from being built out of people's way. I will just say that, so this bill, just for clarity, this is a bill about an existing housing model that builds housing for seniors, but largely doesn't provide services. There is an estimate from Leading Age, which is a statewide organization that promotes the needs of seniors, that we're proposing as much, perhaps as much as $2 million a year for a program like this. There were 16 100-unit buildings, and the expectation is that if you could provide basic service for seniors who are aging in these buildings and need medical services and other things, that if they effectively access those things, the cost avoidance in terms of better health outcomes and you know, fewer hospitalizations and all those things would be a substantial net savings. So we're proposing a pretty modest program to serve, again, 1,600 seniors whose housing has been already constructed and subsidized by the state, but they're basically very limited services available. So that's what, just for clarity, that's what this bill is about.
Move the bill.
I got a motion from Senator Helming, a second from Senator May. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance with our recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-2263, Senate Sponsor Sanders, an act to amend the Real Property Actions and Proceedings Law in relation to prohibiting the eviction of tenants for the certified medical use of medical marijuana.
Okay, so this is a bill that passed the Senate in 2023. Any questions or discussion? We've obviously seen it before. Senator,
yeah, I know we've discussed this before, but I don't recall. If there's a prohibition against smoking in a rental unit, would this allow them to basically smoke marijuana?
Medical marijuana in New York State, unless there are other people who know a lot more about marijuana law than I do, but medical marijuana, as I understand it currently, is not, you cannot be certified to smoke marijuana for medical purposes. So these are people who are using marijuana for medical purposes pursuant to a medical, you know, to a prescription effectively. You wouldn't be smoking for that.
Are they required to provide proof that they actually have a medical need and a prescription?
We would be making it clear that medical marijuana use cannot be the basis for an eviction. So if somebody were bringing a case and saying we're evicting a person for use of medical marijuana, presumably the tenant would, if the landlord was saying we're doing it for medical use, presumably the tenant would provide evidence of that. The landlord certainly could say we're evicting them for any number of other reasons,
right,
that might be legitimate. But
is this a problem? I mean, are there people being evicted for using medical marijuana?
This bill has been around for a few years before actually the legalization of cannabis, but the sponsor and some of our colleagues believe that this is, there are evictions for illicit drug activity that go on. I think that the sponsor here wanted to make it clear that this was something that the law is silent on this, and it makes it clear here. And again, we have passed this bill through the Senate now, I think a couple of years running, and the Assembly hasn't taken it up at this point.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Move the bill.
Senator Jackson, I have a motion to move the bill. Again, this would be a motion to report to the floor. Second by Senator May. Any negative votes?
No.
Senator Burrell, any votes to advance without recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-2506A, Senate Sponsor Kavanaugh, an act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to creating a new acquisition fund for community land trusts located in New York State.
Again, this is a bill also that was reported to finance last year. Any questions or discussion?
How much is money been allocated, or what's the allocation?
In past budgets, we've included money for land banks, and there is some relation between that approach and land trust, but there's not currently a land trust fund that gets allocated funding. So the purpose here is to create this structure, but it would be subject to appropriation, and we would be looking to have a conversation about funding for this in the budget discussion.
Because I support community land trust, I just was wondering how much money was allocated and anything as of yet. Not yet, you're saying that has to be worked out?
Yeah, this would effectively create a mechanism and some parameters about how this might work.
Okay.
But, you know, on an annual basis, we would have a conversation about how much money is worth, you know, putting it in. And community land trusts do serve a very wide range of purposes around the state, including permitting, you know, land acquisition more cheaply in construction for various kinds of affordable housing, both single family and sometimes also multifamily development and preservation.
Okay.
Senator May?
Yeah, so in Syracuse, we're going to have a bunch of land freed up by the removal of I-81 through the city, and there's a lot of talk about community land trusts as a way to figure out what to do with that land for the people who are already living in the area to figure that out. I did want to say, at our hearing on concentrated poverty last month for the Cities 2 committee, one of the things that we heard is that when the state's doing anything to promote affordable housing, it typically wants 100% affordable housing, and that can actually further concentrate poverty in some of our upstate cities. And so that's just a little issue for me we can talk about, but I do think different parts of the state need a different mix of low-income housing. We already have so much in our upstate cities concentrated in a few neighborhoods that we need to figure out how to do the mixed income housing a little bit better too.
Right, and I appreciate it. I spent a couple of days in Buffalo last week to sort of learn what's going on there and meet with lots of folks and talk with some colleagues. So it really is our intention to create genuinely, I mean, I was going to say statewide, but programs that work for each part of the state with a recognition that what might work in Syracuse or Buffalo might be very different than what works in Brooklyn or Manhattan or Long Island or the Hudson Valley. So if you have further, you know, land trusts are a very flexible tool that can be used very differently by different organizations that create them in different places. But the point is very well taken. We do need to make sure that we're addressing
Senator Campbell,
real conditions. Yes?
Would this have any impact on land banks?
Not directly. I mean, in principle, a land bank, you know, so we have an existing land banks program, which was the sort of statutory land banks program was intended to deal with give localities a mechanism for taking
it's
land through tax foreclosure.
It's working extremely well.
Right.
Extremely well.
So it's been
been
a very effective tool around the state. This is not intended to compete with that, but it could, you know, a land bank could use a land trust as a mechanism that would be available for them to, you know, to transfer ownership or to create different financing. So this is a very flexible tool, and we think formally creating it in statute and making sure that they're eligible to receive funding would be a valuable step.
Move.
A motion from Senator Borello, second by Senator Salazar. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-3231, Senate sponsor Hoylman Segal, an act to amend the public housing law in relation to the definition of family member.
And this bill, we'll be looking for a motion to report this to the floor. We did report it to the floor last year. Any questions or discussion?
Bill.
A motion from Senator Jackson, second by Senator Salazar. Any negative votes?
Negative.
Senator Borello and Senator Helming in the negative. Any votes to advance without recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-3334, Senate sponsor Mayor, an act to amend the executive law in relation to standards for the erection of tents or membrane structures.
This is a bill that passed the Senate. We'll be looking for a motion to report it to the floor. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
I got a motion from Senator Jackson, second by Senator May. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-3566B, Senate sponsor Clear, an act to amend the general business law and the real property law in relation to providing expanded home ownership opportunities for the conversion of certain residential rental buildings to condominium status by property owners that commit to the stewardship of permanently affordable units and the preservation of expiring affordable housing inventory in the City of New York, and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof.
We'd like to have at least one lengthy bill title per meeting. We'll be looking for a motion to report this to finance. This is a new bill for this committee. Any questions or discussion?
Move to bill.
Got a motion from Senator Jackson. Second by Senator May. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance the bill without recommendation? Okay, ADR from Senator Barello and Senator Humming. Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-5198, Senate sponsor Scoopus, an act to amend the real property law in relation to increases of rent in manufactured home parks.
And we'll be looking for a motion to report this to the floor as we did last year. Any questions or discussion? Senator Salazar.
Just a comment, it won't surprise you, Chair, that I'm enthusiastically supportive of this bill, and I hope that the session, the Senate will also take up legislation to try to protect other tenants, not only in manufactured home parks, but others from price gouging and unjustified rent increases.
But it does not, it indeed does not surprise me, but thank you for coming. And we have, you know, we have where manufactured mobile home parks are the source of about 180,000 households. It is a source of affordable housing all over the state. This is very much a not New York City issue. There's only a single manufactured mobile home park in New York City. It is in Staten Island. So this is something that we've worked hard to protect, you know, those families as well. So, and this is a step to, you know, to add a little more teeth to a particular provision that was passed in 2019. Any further discussion?
No.
Do we have a motion from Senator May?
Second.
Second by Senator Jackson. Any negative votes?
No.
Got Senator Barello and Senator Humming in the negative. Any votes to advance without recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-5905, Senate sponsor Bridgeport, an act to amend the real property actions and proceeding laws in relation to prohibiting naming dependent children under the age of 18 in petitions to recover possession of real property and eviction warrants and sealing any records pertaining to such children.
Okay, this is also a bill that passed the Senate last year. We'll be looking for a motion to report it to the floor. Any questions or discussion?
Well, I wholeheartedly support it. A child should not be held liable for whatever their parents are doing. So it's just not right, especially when an age for adulthood is 18 or 21, depending on where you are and what you're drinking and stuff like that. But a child 16 and 15 should be responsible? No. So this bill is right on time and should have been done several decades ago, in my opinion.
Right, and the sponsor has noted that if your name is on an eviction warrant, it might hamper your ability to get housing in the future. And again, if you're a minor in the household, whatever the dispute is between the tenant of record and the landlord, the idea here is that children should not be involved in that, formally involved in those proceedings. Any further discussion, questions? Do I have a motion? A motion from Senator May, second by Senator Salazar. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without recommendation? Senator Barello and Senator Humming, AWR, the bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-7863, Senate sponsor Kavanaugh, an act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to increasing the amount an eligible applicant may spend for approved administrative costs associated with administering the Access to Home program.
So again, this is a program that we've been supportive of in the past, including a substantial increase in the amount of funding available in the program. What this bill does is add a modest increase in the amount that our local community organizations who administer this program can use to make sure they're administering it properly. So it raises that from a current statutory 7.5% of the program up to a contract amount of 10%. We will be looking for a motion to report this to the floor. It is a new bill. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Motion from Senator Jackson, seconder from Senator Salazar. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without recommendation? The bill is reported. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.